Dear learners, welcome to NIOS Studio. This is Reena Raghi. Today, we will study Emergence of Regional States in India, 12th and 18th century. Now, with the expansion of Delhi Sultanate, the regional centers, the regional states that existed at the time became the part of the Delhi Sultanate. Now, we'll discuss what led to the emergence of regional states during the given period. The main reason was the weakening of two major empires, that is the Delhi Sultanate and the mighty Mughal Empire, which led to the emergence of regional states. Now, the question arises, what are regional states? Regional states. Now, if you look at the map, you'll find many smaller states that existed in India before as well as after the Delhi Sultanate. The present map is of 1400 AD. You can clearly see the Bahamani and the Vijayanagar Empire, which were the two major kingdom, the regional states of the time. Now, what leads to emergence of regional states? There can be many reasons. It may emerge due to conquest by an outsider, emergence of economically powerful groups asserting their power, local administrative head declaring itself independent when the ruler at the center became weak, as was the case with the weakening of Delhi Sultanate and the Mughal Empire. Now, the first point that we have, the conquest of an outsider. Most of the states in regional India, even the Sultanate rulers, the Mughal rulers, they were all outsiders. Similarly, some smaller rulers also came to India and they were able to conquer a particular region and form a state there. The second point that we have here, the emergence of economically powerful group asserting their power. Here, with the improvement in economy, especially the agricultural economy, trade and commerce became, and the few class who had control over these agricultural resources, they started asserting themselves. Now, local administrative head declaring itself independent was the most common feature which led to the regional emergence of regional states in India. Now, what are the features of a regional states? Now, these states, they have, generally they have a regional dynasty. These states have their distinctive culture and religious cult and tradition, distinctive art form and even architecture. Regional states not always leads to conflict and chaos, but it also influences the craftsmanship and art from one another. We will focus on few of the regional states, as there were so many, it's difficult to talk about all in a class. So we have chosen few, and from all the four directions of India, like from the east, we have Jaunpur and Bengal, west Gujarat, north Kashmir, south Bahamani Kingdom and the Vijayanagar Empire. Now, Delhi Sultanate came into existence with conquering of these regional territories. As a result, whenever these regional territories got the opportunity to become independent, they tried to become independent. This led to continuous conflict. And this also inspired Muhammad bin Tughlaq to move his capital from Delhi to Daulatabad. He thought by shifting his capital, he can control his territory better. Now, death of Firoz Shah Tughlaq led to decline of the Delhi Sultanate. Timur's raid in 1398 led to final disintegration of the empire. This is the picture of city of Daulatabad that was founded by Muhammad bin Tughlaq. But because of scarcity of water, he went back to Delhi. Now, the first regional state that we are going to discuss here is Jaunpur. And here, the governor of Jaunpur, Malik Sarwar, was a prominent noble during Firoz Shah Tughlaq. And he declared himself independent after Timur's invasion. Here, we saw a new style of architecture developed, evolved, that came to be known as Sarki style of architecture, which had Hindu influence. The continuous conflict between the Sultanate and the ruler of Jaunpur finally led to Sikandar Lodi, Jaunpur. With this, the ruler of Sarki came to an end. Now, next regional states, that is Kashmir. The early rulers of Kashmir were followers of Shiva. But in 1939, Samsuddin Shah took over Kashmir and Islam influenced the society of Kashmir. Slowly, most of the poor people in Kashmir, they began to embrace Islam. And from then onwards, Islam became an integral part of Kashmir. Jainul Abidin was known as Akbar of Kashmir. Why he was known as Akbar of Kashmir? We can say that because he had tried his best to bring back the Hindus who had fled earlier from Kashmir to come back to Kashmir. And during his period, art and craft also developed. He sent the artisans from Kashmir to Samarkand. And that's how we have the craft of papier-mâché, very popular in Kashmir, and it developed during his rule. Agriculture, he also promoted development of agriculture. The Mughal Empire finally took over Kashmir in 1586. Next regional state that we'll take is Bengal. Bengal was the easternmost province of Delhi Sultanate. Long distance made it difficult for the Sultanate to control Bengal. The noble Haji Ilyas Khan became independent ruler of Bengal, as was the case in most of the cases after weakening of the central power. Persian was the administrative language of Bengal, but Bangla developed as regional languages. Many literature and artwork, literary work came in this language. Chaitanya and Vaishnava sect was popular among Hindus of Bengal. In the year 1538, Sher Shah Suri finally annexed Bengal. This picture, we see how Chaitanya and his followers were. Next regional state we'll take up is Gujarat. It's from the western part of India, and even today we have a state in this name. Zafar Khan, the governor of Gujarat, became independent and assumed the title of Muzaffar Shah. Another ruler, Ahmad Shah, founded the city of Ahmedabad and made it his capital in 1413. A new style of architecture developed here that had influence of Jain architecture and that can be visible throughout the city of Ahmedabad. Some rulers of this dynasty were great patron of art and literature. The state was conquered by Akbar in 1572 and thus became part of the Mughal Empire. Here we have a glimpse of city of Ahmedabad that was built during this period. Now, the most famous of all the regional states that we can say existed in India were the Bahmani and the Vijayanagar Empire. In the 14th century, two powerful kingdoms arose in the Deccan, the Bahmani Kingdom and the Vijayanagar Empire. Now, Bahmani Kingdom was founded by a person, Haran Kangu, who was official of the Sultanate. He took the title of Alauddin Hasan Baham Shah, and thus the name of Bahmani Sultanate arose. Next was the Kingdom of Vijayanagar Empire, which was founded by Harihara Bukka on the bank of River Tungabhadra. Bahmani and Vijayanagar Empire both had well-developed administrative system and the army. Both the armies, they were well aware of the use of gunpowder. There were constant conflict between the two over Raichur Dov. Now, why Raichur Dov? Raichur Dov was the most fertile area of the region and was also known as the rice bowl. Here, you can see the extension of the Bahmani kingdom during the after the breakup of the Sultanate. And this is the extension of the Vijayanagar Empire. Both the kingdoms were always in conflict and they overlooked the increasing power of the Portuguese and also made them economically weak. This constant conflict made them economically weak. Their rivalry is often looked as Hindu-Muslim conflict, but the conflict was mainly for dominance and control over economic resources. Vijayanagar under Krishna Dev saw construction of many temples in the state. Bahmani architecture had Islamic influence. Not only conflict but sharing of ideas in the field of art, literature and architect also took place between the two. Bahmani kingdom was taken over by Vijayanagar Empire, and by 1646 the Vijayanagar power also came to an end. Here you can look at two of the pictures. One, the Lotus Temple at Hampi, which is today a World Heritage Site, is the perfect example of Vijayanagar Empire's, the architecture that developed in Vijayanagar Empire. The other one, the Gol Gumbaj at Bijapur, is a good example of the Bahmani architecture. Now, till now what we have studied was the regional states that emerged after the breakup of the Sultanate. Now we will focus on emergence of regional states on weakening of the Mughal Empire. Under the Mughal Empire, after the weakening of the Mughal Empire, we saw three kind of regional states emerging. One, the most common one, the state where the local heads started ruling independently without declaring themselves independent. The example, Bengal, Awadh and Hyderabad. Here, all the three Nawabs, they declared themselves independent without gaining independence from the center. The new rulers tried to do away with the system of administration which allowed them to come to power. They tried to bring certain changes which had made them come to power because of the system. Second type of state, known as Watan Jagirs. Watan Jagirs were the states under the Mughal Empire who had to pay tribute to the Mughal Empire for their self-rule, or we can say autonomous, to enjoy the autonomous ruling power. On weakening of the empire, they stopped paying tribute and started ruling their states independently. The Rajputana states fall to this category. Like today, all the states, Udaipur, Jaipur, Jodhpur, all were Watan Jagirs of Mughal Empire, and they all became independent after weakening of the Mughal Empire. The third category came into existence with the emergence of powerful personalities who led rebellion against the Mughal authority. The Sikhs, the Marathas and the Jats belong to this category. We all are aware of Shivaji, how he was in constant fight with the Mughal power at the center, and with their personality, their power, they created a state for themselves. Now here we can look at the expansion of the Mughal Empire, and the bottom part of the map of India, you can see the regional states that were there during 600 AD. Today, if you look at the map of India, we can, though they are not independent states, they are part of the Indian Union, but most of the state, they have their own language, their own culture. So the regional character still exists in India. We have focused on few of the regional states, and there existed many more such states during 12th to 18th century India. Regional states existed even before the 12th century India, and it exists even today. Most of the states in today's India can trace their origin from the earlier region of regional states, like Kashmir. Part of Jammu and Kashmir, we have still the name of Kashmir exists. Gujarat, Rajputana is Rajasthan, present-day Rajasthan comprises of the Rajputana states. Regional states exist even today in India. We can trace different languages. All the states, almost different states of India, they have their own language today. Art and culture, food habits. So this regionalism still exists. Thank you. Hope you liked the lesson.